Hi friends, welcome to my channel Simple Learning Tips. So in today's video, we'll discuss about part 2 of leadership theories. And so far in my previous video, I have covered definition, trait theories, behavioral theories, Blake and Mountain's managerial grade contingency theory, in that Fiddler contingency theory. So if you haven't seen that, please first watch that video so that you will have better understanding of this video. So let's move on to today's video. And for that, I'll leave the link in the description box as well as in the iCard above. Please do check that. So in today's contingency theories, we'll be first moving on to the topic situational leadership theory. Okay. Now, see, from that word meaning, situational leadership theory, you can understand that situation is there, leadership theory is there. So this theory, it basically focuses on followers. Okay, now they state that or they suggest that a leader should choose a leadership style based on the follower's willingness and the ability to work on a goal. Okay, so I hope it is clear. I'll repeat once again that a leader should choose a leadership style based on the willingness of the followers and the ability that the followers have. Now, in that there are certain permutation or combination of there. Like, see, if a follower is unable and unwilling, so he don't have any kind of talent and he is also not willing to work. In that situation, in that kind of situation, the leader should follow a directive kind of leadership. That is, he should give very specific directions. He should give clear-cut instructions to the followers. Okay. Now, the next one, unable and he is willing. Okay. That is, he does not have the ability to work, but he is willing to work. In such kind of situation, the leader should focus more on task. Okay. He should give more guidance related to task. Because these people, they have the ability, they have the willingness to do the work. So, focus more on task completion. And next one, able and unwilling. Now, here, able and unwilling means they have the talent, they have the ability to work, but they are not willing to work. Now, here, they have to use more easygoing kind of leadership style, a more participative kind of leadership style, you know, make them involved in the work that you're doing, ask them to participate in the decision making so that they are, you know, they are more willing to work. Okay. So a kind of friendly leadership style. Next one and the last one, able and willing. So if a follower or if an employee is has the ability to work and also the willingness to work, here leader doesn't have much of work. The followers will do everything by themselves. Next one, path goal theory. Now, this was actually developed by Robert House, and this is kind of in alignment with the expectancy theory of motivation. If you have seen my video, I have explained in motivation theory, Bloom's expectation motivation theory. Again, I'm please suggesting that if you haven't seen that video, please see that video. I'll leave the link in the icon as well as the description box below. So in that video, I have explained that, you know, I have explained that about the Bloom's expectation theory. Now, this is kind not similar to that, but this is in relation to that. Okay. Now, here what they are saying is, a leader tries to remove all the kind of performance block, whatever blockage or whatever obstacles the followers are facing, the leader will remove that and he will clarify the path to achieve the goals. Okay, that leader will do. Now, this leader's behavior will have a great impact or effect on the followers or the employees' perception about what? About his expectations of the effort and the performance that he has to give. So basically, it means that, you know, the leadership style has an impact on the expectation of employees' effort and performance. That is what it means simply. let's say, so there are two factors here, or there are two not variables, there are two things here. Okay, one is there is a leadership style, that is the way in which a leader removes the obstacles to achieve the goal, and the employee's perception about their expectations, perception about the expectations of the effort and performance. Okay, so there are two things. Now, what are the various leadership style? First one is directive. Directive is a kind of autocratic style of leadership. Now, here they, you know, they kind of set target, and if they don't achieve it, they will try to, you know, punish the employees. That is, they will, you know, try to take disciplinary action against them, and if they perform, they will give rewards. Okay, so here the leader, what he will do is that he will make understand the subordinates what is expected from him, and if he does not perform according to the benchmark, he will take action against them. Okay, so that is directive. Like I said, it's kind of autocratic. Now, next one is supportive. Now, supportive means he's a people friendly leadership. Here, you know, they do pay attention to the employee needs, their concern, their welfare, and their well-being. Okay. Next one is participative. Participative means here the leaders, they consult with the employees, and they also involve employees in decision making, and they share information with them. Okay. And, you know, information with the subordinates. It's a kind of group decision making. Okay. And it is like they set the goals together, and the task that has to become complete, and whatever obstacle is there, they try to, or whatever difficulties are there, they try to solve together. So it is more of participative from the word meaning. Next one is achievement oriented. Now here the leaders, they give kind of challenging goals, and they expect that, you know, their subordinates are capable to accomplish that kind of challenging goals. So that is achievement oriented. Okay. Now, like I said, there is a relationship between leadership style and effectiveness of the performance. Okay. So what are the various situations, or what are the various expectations? Like, you know, first one is employee traits. Employee traits means what are the employees' perception or expectation of their needs. Okay, see, as a team leader, you will think that, okay, these are the things, maybe money is a factor for the employee, or maybe, let's say, a kind of medical packages is the expectation, is the need of an employee. Maybe that particular team member need more appreciation, okay, or he values more, more encouragement, okay, something like that. So, it depends on the employee needs. What is that employee wants? Also, their, you know, their talent, the ability to work. Okay, ability to work means their, you know, their competency, the accuracy, their speed. Okay, all that things matters. Then their experience, and also, you know, their job satisfaction level. So, for example, see, if a person is highly talented, then, you know, you can give that employee a supportive kind of leadership style, right? If a person is very good, has a good talent, just give him, you know, a little push so that he will accomplish the task. Next one, work environment. Now, work environment is very important. See, if it is, if it is very organized one, okay, organized work environment, that everything is organized, everything is systemized, everything has a, you know, perfect system, like proper organized, even in your house, you know, if everything is in place, is in order, then, you know, you don't have much work to do. You can easily complete any task easily. So suppose you're cooking, and, you know, you have all the things labeled and everything in a bottle and all that. So you can take that and you can cook. It will take less time and less effort. But if nothing is in order, it's chaos. Every time you will have to check where are the spices I've kept, where are the vegetables I've kept, like that. Same way, if it is a task structured organization, okay, everything is organized, well planned, means the leadership that they can use is kind of participative. Okay, there will be less work for the leaders to do. So that is what the this work environment means. And also, you know, if
for example, if the group unity is less, in such kind of thing, rather than using a directive kind of leadership, they can even use more supportive kind of leadership style to promote more team closeness, everything. Okay, so I hope it is clear. It is very simple, basically understanding the leadership style and how to improve the path to achieve the goal. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Let's move on to next model. See, these are all part of contingency model. Okay, so the last one is leadership participation model. I'm just mentioning it. Okay, I'm not going too much detail into that. So this was actually developed by Victor Room and Philip Yetten, and so in this theory, it suggests that leadership style should be based on how they are participating in decision making, and also it depends on the task structure, like leadership participation model. Okay, so the style should depend on the decision making participation control. So they have certain variable. Actually, this theory has lot of limitations because of the complexity of the model. Actually, it is very simple only, but there are a lot of variables which are missing. So this theory has faced a lot of criticism. Now, moving on to next, we have leader member exchange theory. Now, this is like one interesting theory, and this I'm sure everybody might have faced. Whether you are working in an organization or you are in a college or you are in a school, everywhere this leadership LMX theory, it applies. Okay. Now here, what it states that the leader will have different kind of relationships with different subordinates. Okay, each subordinates they will have, or let's say groups of subordinates, let's say rather than saying individual. We can say that leader has a different kind of relationship with each groups. Okay. For example, I'll first give the example, then I'll explain the theory. See, whether you are in college or you are in an office environment, if you have a teacher, okay, that some cases, not all the teachers, some cases teacher favors certain group of students, maybe who are very studious, they'll pay more attention to them, and the resources and all will be easily available to them rather than the average performing students. Okay, it is not good. I'm just saying some people, some faculties, they do that. Okay, not all exams. I'm not generalizing. So, same in organization, the leader will have their favorite group. And wherever they are going because of, a time constraint or because of the special relationship they have with this group, they will take this entire group along with them. And even the people who are in there, they will have special obligation towards this leader. And, because of this, the group members will get a lot of privileges. So, this is known as the group which is favored, okay, by the leader. That group is known as in-group. And the group which is outside this group, that is, that are not favored by the leaders, they are known as out-group. So, that is what leader-member exchange theory. Now, this in-group people who are favored by the leaders, they will get more attention from the leaders, they will have more organizational resources, okay, and they will have more, privileges than the other group. Whereas, for the other group, definitely they will get less resources or input from the leader because they are not favored by the leader, the out-group, okay. So, that is leader-member exchange theory. I hope it is clear. So, let's move on to next, because these are, very easy one. If you just go through it, you will understand. Next one, charismatic theory. Now, charismatic theory. So, like I've written here, this theory states that followers acknowledge heroic or extraordinary leadership abilities when they observe certain behavior. So, charismatic leader. See, the word charisma, okay, a charm, an aura. Okay, that is what a kind of magic. So these people are like kind of superhuman, supernatural kind of leaders. Okay, they are visionary, and they put forward a very futuristic, very futuristic ideas. They will have and you know they are the people who are ready to take great personal risk, and you know they are self-sacrifice people to achieve the goal or vision, and even they are very sensitive towards the followers, towards their follower, and they use you know all the kind of new things. Okay, they proposes all these kind of new, and also they do new things which you might never have heard before. Okay, for example, so these kind of leaders are known as charismatic leaders. These are their characteristics. For example, if I say Elon Musk, SpaceX and Tesla owner, Tesla founder, Indira Nooyi, former CEO of PepsiCo, Barack Obama. Okay, all these people, all these leaders are charismatic leaders. Okay. Are examples of charismatic leaders. So they have a kind of, basically what I'm saying, trying to say is that they have kind of individual personality that makes them exceptional, that distinguishes them from others. Okay, they have a kind of aura. Sorry. So I hope it is clear. Next one is transformational theory. Now, transformational theory, like I've written here, these kind of leaders, you know, they encourages their followers to, you know, excel their self-interest for the wellness of the organization, for the benefit of the organization. So, and they have an extraordinary influence on the followers. That is what transformational leaders are. Okay. So, what are their major characteristics are? You know, they have a very good sense of mission. They have a very good sense of vision, pride. You know, they have a lot of respect from their followers, and they have a lot of trust, confidence from their followers. And, you know, they always communicate with a lot of high expectations. And, you know, their life will be very simple, and also their purpose in life also very simple. And they care for intelligence. They even promote intelligence. And you know they're very very diligent. They're in problem solving. Okay. And for the followers, they give personal attention to each and every follower they have. And you know they try. They coach. They influence. They advise. They give advice to each employee. So that is transformational leader. They transform their followers. Okay. For what? So that the followers best can be given to achieve their goals. That is, they will try to identify individual's self-interest. What is that the individual has? And they try to groom that. They try to mold that interest so that, you know, their best can be brought out and it can be used for the organization benefit. Okay. So that is what transformation. They literally change everything. Okay. And they have a huge influence on their followers. For example, Mahatma Gandhi, Martin Luther King, then Nelson Mandela, Jeff Bezos. Okay. He was a person who started this online business, Amazon, for selling books. And now you can imagine, like, Amazon is a common name even in our country, right? In India, right? So, that is the transformation. Like, you know, everybody is like, okay, we have to purchase something, let's go to Amazon. Okay, not online, we generally say Amazon, we'll try Amazon. Okay, so that is the transformation that he has created. Steve Jobs about Apple. So these are the some of the examples of transformational leaders. Okay, and please, it's a humble request from me, try to read biographies of these people, or you know, from net, or if you could afford books, you know, please buy books about them. Definitely that will influence your life. Okay, that could have a huge impact on your life. Okay, so with this, again, the video is getting very long. So because there are a lot of leadership theory, now we have only two pending leadership theory, Likert's management system and Hersey Blanchard model. So I'll uploading part 3 of this leadership theory soon. Don't worry, I'll upload it next week itself. So with that, I'll conclude this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to share and subscribe to this channel, and please leave your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching this video, and stay tuned for more videos like this. Thank you.